race. She started her winning ways in 1979. Australia in lane two and Ward and Katrin Borchert. The very experienced pairing here in lane four, Andersson and Gunnarsson, nine times in the Olympic Games between the two of them. Here are Koban. Koban's there in the stern and Mednyanszky in the bow. The two Germans, Birgit Fischer. Fischer facing you with Ramona Portwich, who won the Olympic title with Anker von Seck in 1992. Then Spain, Aramburu and Manchon, both 20 years of age. And then in lane number eight, watch out for these two very useful Canadians. This is Marie-Josee Gibeau. Gibeau's in front and Kennedy behind. Then in lane number nine, it is the French pair, Sabine Kleinheinz facing you. And behind, it's Severine Loyot Kleinheinz, who won the Downriver World Championship in 1989 on the Savage River in Maryland. That was a race over 7 kilometers. This, just 500 meters. They're outsiders, but they would do well to medal here. So who's going to take the final medal of the regatta? We'll shortly know in less than 2 minutes from now. So can Birgit Fischer and her partner Ramona Portwich give them a final memory of the Olympic regatta? They've gone out really quickly now, the Germans. Watch for the Swedes as well to come late. And starting very quickly, closest to you are the two Poles, Dylewska and Urbanczyk, who were silver medalists in the world and sixth in the Olympic Games 4 years ago. And they've got their bow to the fore at the moment. The French on the far side, the Canadians are ahead of them, and the Germans have got some paddling to do. That's Portwich there in the stern of that boat, and they're really getting motoring now, and the Germans coming through, and they've got the call at the moment as we come down to the half distance, 250 meters to go. Could this be another amazing medal? It would be gold medal number six if Birgit Fischer, who's already got gold in the German K4, can do this with Portwich, and they go through with just about a quarter of a boat length ahead, but they're really being pursued now by the Swedes, Andersson and Gunnarsson, with King Gustav and Queen Sylvia watching on now as they try to move into second place. Watch out also for the Canadians, who are two from the top of the picture with the white hats, and the Germans now pulled it out to half a length, but we've still got 150 meters to go. They've really got to give everything for this, with Birgit Fischer still holding the lead. Here come the two Swedes at the moment, Birgit's children Ulla and Ola, with Mama Ursula watching at home back in Germany. Still they have the advantage at the moment from the Swedes, who are coming. This is Agneta and Andersson and Gunnarsson coming towards them now, coming towards the line. The Germans have got it, but no, Sweden now get the bow ahead of the Germans, and it's Sweden in the gold medal position, with closing very fast the Australians as well. But it's Sweden who take gold, Germany who takes silver, and it looks to me as Australia and Wood and Katrin Borchert of Australia coming late on the pace to snatch the bronze medal. And that's the second bronze for Australia in the morning. But Andersson and Gunnarsson, my goodness, they've had to wait a long time, the Swedes, to get this gold medal. But the King and the Queen absolutely delighted. The Swedish women, who got a bronze medal yesterday in the K4, and now they've taken the gold in the K2, and Birgit Fischer has a third silver Olympic medal. In the end there, it was pretty decisive, but they paced it really well, these two Swedish women. Andersson, she's in the front. Agneta, who lives in Australia, was the Olympic champion in K1. And K2 back in 1984 in the Los Angeles game, five times an Olympian, and now back in America, she strikes gold again. And Andersson, Susanne Andersson, fourth Olympic champions for her. Andersson, Gunnarsson, I should say, who's sitting, she's at the back of the boat there in the stern, absolutely delighted. Second in Los Angeles in the K4, second in the K2 in 1992, third in the individual K1 championship last year. Two amazing talents, evergreens really. They're 35 years and 32 years of age respectively. They retain their appetite, but they retain their skill, their speed, and they give Sweden the final gold of the regatta. terrific performance, good time, 1:39.03 ahead of Portwich and Fischer. Germany were the Olympic champions ahead of Sweden and Hungary in 1992, but now the Swedes have turned the tables and Australia confirmed an excellent bronze for them. It's their, just counting up, I think it's their third of the regatta now. Clint Robinson got one on day one in the 1,000 metres, and just checking through, I'm sure they've got another one today, but the yes indeed, Andrew Trim and Danny Collins in the men's K2 500, and now their women have done it in the last race here at Lake Lanier. So what a special moment this will be for the Swedes, who were disappointed in the rowing finals, but finally at the last gasp their two most experienced paddlers come through for glory, joy and immortality. Birgit Fischer just above there leaning back, but she has nothing to, she'll be disappointed, but she has nothing to be ashamed of. An amazing career, Birgit Fischer.